Tom Olson. I'm the production coordinator here at Enterprise Farm in Whately. It's mid-March, so this is the sort of the first greenhouse that we start production in. The Enterprise is a 120-acre organic vegetable production farm. We have a CSA that's anywhere from 500 to 700 members. We're trying to keep it at like 500. So we do wholesale too. We do direct store delivery to Whole Foods, and we have other various wholesale accounts. So we have it's sort of a complex operation as far as like doing a farm plan for all those three factors, all those three facets of the farm. So but this is basically how we start production. Everything is seeded in flats that either have 98 or 128 cells. They get big, then we take them out and transplant them in the field. We have, think about Enterprise, we have fields all over, sort of like in a 5-10 mile radius in both Franklin and Hampshire County, which makes it kind of a challenge because they're, you know, they're various sizes, anywhere from like a half acre to an acre to like 10 acres, 11 acres. I think there are like 26 different plots now that we have, so we have to, you know, obviously when you do an organic farm plan on a yearly basis, you have to follow a sort of 3 to 5 year rotational system for the crops. You can't plant the same crop in the same field year after year, or even like 2 years afterwards. So that's part of the challenge, is sort of assigning each crop to what field when you have so many crops. Probably plant maybe 30 varieties of different things, of all sorts of vegetables, from brassicas, tomatoes, things like fennel, root vegetables in the fall, which is especially popular for the CSA. So the greenhouse is where it's all the production starts and pretty much ends too. This is pretty much the first seeding for various things. Like, we do a lot of kale, obviously. Every organic farm does a lot of kale. So this is kale, dandelion. I just seeded some tomatoes down there too for the first time for the greenhouse that we have over here where we do greenhouse production. So what else? Kale, we got some dandelion too. We're seeding broccoli today. So we're right at the start of the season. This is what a farm looks like in March, basically. Right before you...
Dandelion, as in the weeds that nobody wants in their lawn.
Yeah. Well, it's just, you know, it's a special kind of variety. A lot of people, we sell a lot of dandelion, actually. You'd be surprised. We have a lot of Jamaicans who work here during the summer too. We grow callaloo, which is something that it's a big crop back, a greens crop, sort of similar to dandelion. And I see, what else does this kind of, it's kind of like it's a green, you know, stir fry with onions and garlic. Yeah. So that's sort of the interesting thing about the valley, is that there's so many Jamaicans around, and callaloo is such a big crop that it's like, you know, callaloo is almost specific to this area during the summer, where it's like nowhere else other than Jamaica. So that's sort of a small fact. We start everything here in greenhouse 3, and then we expand to the other two. We've got 2 greenhouses there, 3 on the other side.
So these are put out in the field?
These will eventually be transplanted into the field. So everything starts here, except for the things that we direct seed, like carrots, chard, you know, squash, etc., like that. So
can you do it with a machine or a truck, or do you have to hand?
No, we have a specific, it's called the transplanter, that is towed behind a tractor, where 2 people or 3 people, depending on the crop that's being transplanted, sort of sit low to the ground and, you know, plop the, it's called plugs. Once these get big, they're called plugs. So you'll have little tray carriers like this, and so you'll sit kind of low and you'll stick them into the ground too. You've seen the black plastic in the fields?
Yeah,
so you go through that and you punch holes into the plastic, and then the tractor goes over that and the people drop the plugs in. It's an interesting system.
Well, this is our farm store. This time of year, in the winter, we are partnering with local and regional farms. Our produce is coming from all over the East Coast. At this point, we have sweet potatoes here from North Carolina. We have some eggs from cage-free eggs from Vermont. We have some butternut squash from Vermont. Celery is and peppers from Florida, potatoes from Canada. So we have things from all over the spectrum. We even get some citrus from, this is from California. We try to get it from Florida, but we can't always get it from there. We're kind of like a distributor partnering with local and regional farms. During the summer, it's all of our own produce that we grow, unless we're bringing in specialty items such as apples from local orchards. So we're about halfway through our winter share now. So this is a good idea of what we have this time of year. We get some greens from Florida, lettuce and kale, cabbage as well. This is a really great local company that grows their own mushrooms right in Hadley, right down the road. We have a lot of produce from Red Fire Farm, like this parsnip. CSA members will come to the farm and they will pick out their produce. So they can pick out whatever they want when they're at the farm. They get a dollar amount. We call this the market share. And so depending on their size, they can just pick out whatever amount of produce as long as it equals that dollar amount, and we have prices on everything. Or people have the option of choosing this list. If they were to get delivered their farm share, this would be what would be in the box. But since they're coming to the farm, they don't have to stick to that list, although some people do. Or they start off with the list and then they might switch something out if they don't like it. Also, our CSA members who pick up at the farm have the option of going out in our pick your own garden. And we have everything from all different types of bell peppers, hot peppers, specialty peppers, heirloom tomatoes, cherry tomatoes, regular tomatoes, flowers, herbs, all different things that people can pick from our pick your own. And that is a huge reason why people come here, because most of our CSA members will preserve food, and so they can really get a bounty out of their summer share.